Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Intel Extreme Masters World Championship. Counterlogic Gaming is one game up over Fnatic. We'll see how that continues in just a bit. But first, I am joined here by Koma, the coach for SK Telecom, and helped by Suzy. SK Telecom just qualified. Congratulations for the semifinal. I want to get your opinion as a coach of why you guys chose to bring Blank to this tournament instead of Bengi.
일단 블랭크를 데려온 이유는 블랭크 선수는 굉장히 유능한 선수인데 경험이 부족해서 경험을도 쌓을 겸 데리고 왔습니다.
Okay, the reason we brought Blank is because he is a very good player, but he needs more experience. So they wanted to give him more experience, and that's why they brought him to this tournament.
He also mentioned in the interview that you guys were offering him special help to help him get over the nerves and to make him acclimatize better. Can you say something more about that?
일단 성구가 굉장히 유능한 선수인데 처음에 이제 무대 경험이 없다 보니까 본 실력이 좀 나오지 않았어요. 근데 처음에 뭐 경기를 좀 이기 그러니까 승리를 좀 맛봤으면은 그런 게 없었을 텐데 좀 많이 져가지고 심리적으로 좀 압박감을 느껴가지고 좀 심리 상담을 받고 있었습니다. 근데 뭐 심리 상담이랑 그렇게 크지 않게 되게 유능한 선수였었는데 처음에 져가지고 좀 이제 위축된 게 굉장히 큰 것 같습니다. 그래서 이제 심리 상담을 받게 됐습니다.
Actually, before the interview, he told me, I give long answers, by the way. He thinks, like he said, Blank is a very good player, and him getting on the team, it's just that he hadn't had much experience, and then consistently losing has really gotten to his head. So they got a psychotherapist to help him out, get over that, but it's not, the psychotherapist helps. He is a very good player already. It's just having him get back into that groove and,
giving him that extra push. Of course, Koma, the last time that we spoke was after you won the World Championship with your team, SKT. A lot has changed since then. Can you give me a little insight as the coach of how different it is to work with this new configuration as to how they were at Worlds?
World Championship.
지금 평가하기에는 너무 어려운 것 같습니다. 작년 이맘쯤에도 이 정도 성적이었기 때문에 이런 질문은 좀 썸머 때나 들어봐야 될 것 같습니다. 지금은 이제 발전하고 있는 단계이기 때문에 팬분들이 좀 이제 아낌없는 격려와 응원해 주셨으면 좋겠습니다.
He said it's a little soon for him to be able to make that distinction right now. Maybe if you ask the question at the end of summer, then he might be able to give a better answer. Because as of right now, this is kind of where they were at last year as well. And...
지금이랑 너무 비슷하고 지금 평가할 단계는 아닌 것 같다고 썸머 때 평가해 달라고.
Yeah, basically, he's going to be able to say a lot more about it at the end of summer because it's just too soon to say.
I might be able to ask you if and when you maybe hoist the cup tomorrow. I do want to get your opinion on the rest of this group, though. We now saw CLG is one game up versus Fnatic. There's also the Jaguar Reapers. Who do you think is going to make it out of this group and why?
B조에서 올라올 팀은 QG가 올라올 것 같습니다.
QG.
All right, we will see how that evolves. Finally, let's say one word about your semi-finalist opponent for tomorrow, Team Solo Mid. How do you think that matchup is going to go?
일단 국제 대회에서 TSM에게 져본 적이 한 번도 없습니다. 그래서 앉을 것 같고 또한 이곳이 유럽이기 때문에 더욱더 질확률은 제로일 것 같습니다. 이곳이 유럽이기 때문에 더욱더 질확률은 제로일 것 같습니다.
They have never lost a game to TSM in an international tournament before, so they're pretty confident that they're going to be able to beat them. And because this is Europe, I mean, they don't have a home crowd advantage or anything like that.
All right, we will see how that plays out. Thank you very much and good luck in the rest of the tournament. Koma, I'm back over to our guys at the desk.
Thank you very much. I, for one, am exceptionally excited about the SKT versus TSM matchup. One more reminder for you guys at home, if you're using Google Chrome, go check out the plays.tv extension. It lets you just cut out clips of your stream and instantly post it to your social media. Maybe these two guys who stream at home can also check it out at some point. Let's talk about CLG versus Fnatic. They're swapping sides this time around. Counterlogic Gaming on the blue side as we're getting ready for picks and bans. What would you change, if anything, in the last game? Kog'Maw, Nautilus, Nidalee is what CLG banned, and Fnatic replied with Fiora, Bard, and Kalista. Would you still leave the Bard in there as a ban?
I mean, I think just the whole pick and ban is going to change now that CLG has the blue side and has to blind pick their top laner. So that's already going to change the whole style. Maybe they go for a tanky style. But you never know. Maybe Fnatic decides to blind pick another top laner before CLG does, which I think is a terrible idea. But
how much can you change your pick and ban strategy coming in? Because earlier today we saw CLG, they played their team fight comp with the tank top. Now they did the Vladimir into Rammus and played split push again, which is what we're expecting. Dexter, you've already sort of mentioned what some of your experience with the CLG staff behind the scenes.
I mean, the picks and bans are preparation of like weeks, right? So coming into this tournament, either you prepared something new or not. And if you run with one style only and don't prepare like another strategy in case it backfires, then yeah, you're pretty much out of the tournament because you have nothing else to play. Or you just try it again and maybe the execution was like bad in that comp. And yeah, that's it. Like, it's all weeks preparation in beforehand. So either you prepared good or not.
Well, we're about to find out how good Fnatic did prepare. The Kalista was banned on blue side. They are now red side. That's a more traditional place to see that Kalista ban. Do you think they're going to do the same again?
I think, realistically speaking, it makes more sense to ban it on red side. So I think the Kalista ban is probably the one we are going to see for sure.
Okay.
But since you're red side, you have less target bans because you have to ban other OP stuff, which different teams consider different stuff OP. For example, Lulu was open this game. Against us, it's never open. Same goes for Alistar or Kalista. But so I think Fnatic is going to use their bans as target bans. Not as target bans, sorry. So there's most likely going to be Bard open for Afremu. Yep. And what was the other ban for Fnatic?
Fiora.
I think there might be a... Yeah, that one is going to be tough. But I think Bard is going to be open for sure.
All right, let's talk a little bit about this Corki pick, because Monte Cristo was basically begging Fnatic or any team to make sure they run it. Yeah. Then he saw Fnatic using it with Febiven. It left a lot to be desired. That's the way I'll put it. What was your take on that pick and how they handled it?
I feel like Fnatic right now is playing a too slow game right now for Corki to make it work. And especially like this tournament, Corki has been underutilized, I think. And sometimes we just see people first pick Corki and make it work because it's just so oppressing and too strong even after the nerfs. It's like a flex pick and it has like a really strong laning phase, and once you get the package and the power spike that we all talk about, level 11 with the Sock Boost Trinity Force, you can just turn teamfights around alone because it's just so strong. And yeah, like I said, Fnatic didn't use it to create anything on the map and it was like pretty bad for them, I think.
I was just mostly surprised about how Lulu was able to TP top lane, TP bottom lane, and still go equal mid lane and be able to move first to every fight. I think there was either like huge miscommunication with Fnatic going on, or just who he is, a god.
But then also why? Like, so miscommunication, I mean, is it also a lack of understanding from Febiven and Fnatic how to play that champion? Because you guys have run Corki and used him relatively well, but how much does it impact your team's play style and communication?
It doesn't really do that much difference, you know? Like, Corki is just this champ that has like a bit of pressure mid, but it's mostly just ungankable, and he just works around that, level 11 power spike that Dexter was talking about. But what I was just surprised was the fact that Lulu was able to TP to other lanes
and still have
the impact. Yeah. So in the mid lane, so it just felt wrong. I felt like there was something going on there that we didn't really notice or watch.
Okay.
So,
well, we'll keep an eye on that mid lane this time around. Nautilus and Kog'Maw, the same two bans that CLG ran in the previous game. Bard, are you surprised by that on red side?
Yeah, I was wrong. So they just proved me wrong by banning Bard.
It's all theory.
Yeah.
You don't have to beat yourself up so much.
Okay.
Lulu follow up again, no real surprise, but Killister still there, Nidalee still there.
CLG should ban Nidalee. I don't think Xmithy is a Nidalee player, and Spirit has been picking Nidalee for like 5 patches already, even when it was super bad. And yeah, if it's not banned, then Spirit's just going to play it and has like a lot of pressure on the map. So I think CLG should just ban Nidalee and play the matchup again. Gragas versus Udyr, it's fine, it's working out for them. Why not do it again?
Yep. Xmithy ran Gragas earlier today, actually ran ZZ Rot on that Gragas. Kalista ban.
This has to be Kalista ban, yeah.
Then that means both Alistar and Braum are available. So what does CLG consider first picking?
Udyr.
And there we go.
Oh, I don't...
So CLG should first pick Gragas here right now, but then it's Kalista open, yeah. Kalista. Now's the thing, what are they going to ban? What are they going to pick into the Gragas? I mean, what's a good pick? I think Elise is fine, but then the pressure's on you to make the plays.
Amazing says Lee Sin is fine.
Yeah.
At least you have the pressure to make the plays. Listen is fine, but you still get outscaled. Like, obviously you get outscaled with most champs, but maybe X-Smithy, I saw him playing Echo long ago. Maybe he plays Echo like Swift did.
Yeah.
Never know.
Tefisho, I think, was talking about that a little bit a long time ago, how Echo was a counter pick into Gragas. I use counter very loosely, but you know, we saw it used earlier today. Do you think it can come back?
I have no idea. Like, I really, I don't want to talk
jungle. That's fine.
Yeah. But maybe, you know, maybe.
Well, I feel the same way about the jungle. It is going to be Elise. That answers
Elise, yeah.
Question for X-Smithy. And you've got the makings of a very strong pick.
Oh, that was fast.
Whoa, Jhin is locked in.
Okay.
Tell me about Jhin, because we've not seen him in Europe yet.
Well, Thresh Jhin is a very, very strong lane. The Jhin bounce on the wave works a bit like the Sivir bounce. It's really annoying to play against, and she has like this crit thing, like this crit last attack too, that does a lot of damage in lane. So her laning power is pretty good. She has good follow-up for Thresh too, and it's just overall a strong champion in lane, but she's very immobile. Therefore, Thresh makes her even better, right? So I think overall the champion is good. I think it's good against the champions that CLG picked. It's not a bad pick at all. It's just that the mobility of Kalista might be a bit too much for her.
Yep. Dexter, what do you make of this Quinn? Do you think it's for Gamsu or Feather?
It should be a flex pick right now. I think Quinn mid lane is incredibly strong and not very utilized by a lot of teams. And I talked with Nuke Dog about their champion because he was like a Quinn main right now. And he said Quinn has no counters. And the item path right now with like more of Mortios first item is like really, really good for them. And we actually see the Pantheon here and the Echo.
Like Echo?
Echo.
So where, who's going where?
Who's going where? That's something we have to find out.
Is that Echo mid or Echo top?
Maybe it's a double flex they have practiced.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be surprised. CLG, as I said before, has a very wide champion pool.
Are they looking for a Echo slash Pantheon into Quinn no matter which lane?
I think the Pantheon should go to like a Quinn's lane no matter where they put them, because Pantheon against Quinn, like, he can match the power really well in lane, and he can block like the auto attacks, and the all-in, the gank facilitation is really, really good in that matchup. So I think they just want to see the Quinn where she goes, and then, yeah, we see it Rammus top lane again. I think it's fine here in that matchup because it should do really well actually against melees.
Mm-hmm. I think Rekkles is going to have a very tough time with Echo, Elise, a Morgana with Fate's Call and Pantheon jumping onto his head. There is some peel there now from Thresh, from Gragas and Rammus, and we know it's going to be a mid lane Quinn.
Yep.
A couple seconds there for CLG to swap around. What do you make of these two team comps and what they want to accomplish, Mithy?
I would be surprised if the Fnatic wants to go 2v2. I mean, I see Klay is hovering over Ignite. Obviously, he can still change, but I just feel like Kalista and Morgana is such a just overall safe lane. You have to outplay them as Thresh Jhin to actually win the lane 2v2. You can. Like, you have tools to outplay, but if they play it right and they don't outplay themselves, you will be pressured. They have at least two to snowball that pressure off, and it's gonna be tough for a 2v2. So, and look at the Pantheon is mid now. So.
Yeah, it should be. If you put Pantheon into Rammus, I think you just straight up lose the game because you won't damage him. And yeah, I think that's like the fine choice here to do that, what CLG is doing. But I feel like the map has to be played like fast-paced because CLG is gonna get outscaled really hard here because the Echo doesn't really do that much in late game, and the Pantheon obviously is like just the early game mid pick, and yeah, I want them to see and be proactive.
The beauty about the game right now is that it's all about fast pace. If you can get a small advantage, well, not small, but if you can get a decent lead early game, you can snowball it through the whole game, and even if you have early game champs, you can win very convincingly if you are a good team.
Gentlemen, you both predicted CLG correct to win in game one. The fans are with Fnatic. Where do your allegiances lie?
I mean, if I remove the name tags, I think Fnatic has like a good draft here.
Okay.
But
so the name tags make you say CLG?
Yeah.
Okay.
I think CLG is going to win this game.
Mithy, who's your prediction?
I would love for Europe to stay in this tournament, but I think that CLG has the better picks.
Sorry to cut you off, guys. We do have to go to the casters as we're about to go into game.
Welcome back, guys, for game number two between Fnatic and CLG. And it's a bit of an insane team composition, guys, isn't it? Yeah, a little bit interesting. All right. What do you think?
A lot of pick potential from both teams here. Yeah. I really like that last rotation from CLG in terms of the flex picking with Pantheon Echo. So if Rammus became the last pick, you would just put Pantheon mid and put an AP champion on top side against the Rammus.
Sure. Well,
yeah.
Welcome to Summoner's Rift. Fnatic trying to tie things up against CLG and avoid being knocked out of the tournament. Dark Binding on the Klai, but it's just like a, you know,
Love tap.
I love dark binding.
I don't know if there are many of those.
A love binding.
Love binding. Well, yeah. I mean, that's a whole different.
You really want to go there, Dom?
That's a whole different book series, I've been told. If I've been just hanging out, what is he doing to that bird? Don't
taunting
shake the bird.
And now everyone punishes him. Yeah, don't taunt
just
the bird.
Love dark binding.
Wow.
It's a cleanse.
So both teams here are going to look to play basically 1-3-1 later on in the game. Ram is sitting top against Echo TPs. Quinn going to side lane against the Pantheon. Pantheon obviously can jump and leave the lane only if he's sitting bot, he can go to mid. Quinn often pushes out recalls and then can roam to multiple lanes with the ulti. So a lot of mobility on both sides and how fast you can kind of jump around. And then Jhin is here, a champion who's very good in laning phase. The way a lot of the European AD carries like to describe him is win lane, lose game. Because as soon as you get out of the laning phase, yep. He's so difficult to execute. And he has zero extra mobility. And against Pantheon, against Echo, two champions who can dive the backline very effectively.
Hey, don't forget your single target CC from Elise and Morgana there.
Sure.
It's a nice range.
Yeah, I mean, normally he works well in pick comps because if you tank something, some damage on a champion and he then connects with his W, he will snare you.
Well,
from very long range, but yeah.
Aphrim was 3-for-3 on dark bindings now in the first 2 minutes of the game. It's a good sign. Who he's going to maybe struggle a little bit against is Quinn.
Pantheon is very focused on being able to all in these matchups, but Quinn has a fantastic level 1, level 2 because of Thunderlords as well, because you can apply the passive so easily and get the extra hits, and you're just very good at early trading. Pantheon won't really be able to follow up just in a few early levels, but he will have good all-in potential later.
Yeah, you really need all three of Pantheon's early abilities if you actually want to all-in, because that's so much more damage if you once you get that Heartseeker strike out there, and we do see.
Well, yeah, and again, no cleanse for this Quinn right here. Fevevin could be in trouble, needs to be careful. Like Smithy just showing himself in the lane, but gotta be careful if you're Fevevin for a little bit longer at least.
Yeah, we heard Smithy talk about Fnatic potential lane swapping, but when you pick Thresh, Jhin as your counter to the Kalista first pick, because they left Kalista open, obviously expecting it to be first picked, and also, again, running offensive summoner on Klai. You almost have to take that 2v2 and now rely on Fnatic winning that lane. They didn't win it last game, got basically outplayed by Aphrimu, and now they're gank mid.
Yep, Klai brings Spirit in, who he on the run right now, has to burn his flash to get out of there, but looks like he'll make it out with his life.
Two flashes.
Yep, Klai used his flash, Smithy, or rather, Huyi used his.
And now you give up lane pressure bot lane, which was the whole point of you taking standard lanes by pulling off this roam. Obviously, Fabian, because he had no cleanse, had to play a bit more passive, but I'm not sure investing everything onto a mid lane gank where you didn't even have a proper setup was very smart.
Well, that Wolf Spirit really didn't see anything, which means that neither did Fnatic. Yep, there's my analysis.
Still in the dark.
Yep. Reckless Klai coming back to lane. Dark binding onto Reckless.
Yeah, he's trying to make some of these trades, but
yeah,
not much they're going to be able to do quite yet here. And looks like it's going to be pretty smooth sailing here for Stixxay and Aphrimu.
It's going to be a pretty quiet early game as well, it seems like.
So there is one thing about that Wolf Spirit, just to go back. The way it works when you smite the Wolf Camp, if someone enters the jungle, the spirit kind of goes crazy and starts rushing over there. Mm. So even though I didn't see them, it technically, you know they were there because it reacted.
Right.
Otherwise, they've just like been hovering around the blue buff.
And it'll immediately start going to whichever choke point they walk through.
True. Well, Fevevin caught, able to get away, had that cleanse up, but had to burn the flash to do it. Who he did use his ignite, they went for it, but they just missed that timer on the summoner spell.
So close though.
Yeah.
Again, now double summoner down, Xmithi can return. So mid lane, Fnatic once again opts into a matchup where you have a jungler who wants to farm for 6, and then you can start making plays. And then we talked about that bot lane having to win 2v2, but I really dislike that early roam from Klai.
And in the top lane, what we saw is Darshan has just been pushing this up, and he actually got back into lane with the double Doran's ring very quickly. He pushed out Gamsu, didn't have to use his TP. Gamsu had to use his, and now we're in this situation.
Darshan on the run, gets a stun onto Gamsu, though. Spirit can't really slow him down enough to make it work, so Darshan gets out of that one without having to burn any summoners, which is nice for CLG.
And when we get later in the game, when we're going to see these soul laners sit in side lanes and trying to 1v1 each other, we have to remember this TP home guard that Rammus is so good at gets hard countered by Morgana. coming in as the support pick. Same in many ways for Jhin and his long range pick potential. If you see his W being charged up, again, you black shield the target and no snare gets fired. Well, it still gets fired, but doesn't snare anyone. Hmm.
Well, we might have a bit of a dive here on Decline and Reckless. No, they know what's up, though. They should. Having him play a little bit more safe. Meanwhile, Huhi under some pressure in the mid lane. Here comes Spirit. Fevivin doing some damage. TP comes in, though, for CLG. Nice stun into Fevivin. They didn't mean that. They might not even need Darshan, but Darshan comes in and takes a kill anyway. First blood for that top lane Echo after the TP.
They definitely did not need Darshan to even TP in there. And there's going to be Huhi following up. No mana, though.
Comes down. Yeah, no mana. Not a lot of life either. Might give one over. No, Klai actually gives a kill to CLG. Huhi barely makes it out. He had sub 50 health for a second there.
Different picks, but still somewhat the same as last game. Let's see if Reckless can get anything. I don't think so. Everyone is just backing away, but Pantheon or Huhi plays well in the mid lane, picks up a kill or an assist in this case, and then instantly he just applied pressure on the side lane, something he did in the last game with Lulu, who managed to TP away twice in the early game, roam away, and still win on farm.
Well, I really like the decisiveness of CLG here, because there was that gank in the mid lane, who he just gets the kill. Well, helps get the kill. It actually was Darshan getting the last hit, even though he wasn't needed.
Well,
immediately responds with the man drop into the bottom lane. So it's just been so quick. He knows his map awareness is very good, and we're going to see another little skirmish.
Yeah, Smithy gets a cocoon onto Fevivin, but Spirit's right there as well. Smithy trying to rappel away, but I don't know if he can quite make it. He's getting really low, and there's a kill for Fevivin. So Fnatic do strike back. And going back to that gank before, as we see who he takes some damage, oh, Spirit's coming in. No, they're just going to pressure the lane. I feel like Darshan was very decisive. He decisively came in and decisively decided that he needed that kill more than anyone else.
I mean, it's better to make those plays than to not make them, and that's the thing. And they still had another global left to affect the bottom side and pick up another kill.
And that teleport is actually something the Asian teams have always been super good at, is whenever a fight breaks out, you just instant TP. And then you can, because it will always mean you get there like 2 or 3 seconds faster, because the other team is trying to cope and like, should I TP? Yes, go for it. No, don't go for it. Sometimes it's a waste. Sometimes it works out and you end up picking up first blood for it. And we often see this with the Asian teams. They are fine wasting a potential teleport just for the fact that if they are late, they could have lost the fight.
Oh, Afrobu coming down with Stixxay. They're going to try to make a play. Fate's Call use. Flash from Klai. Manages to take Reckless out. Oh, they get him with the Dark Binding anyway, though. Hook misses, or actually Hook blocked by the shield. Stixxay does the damage. There's the Ren for the kill onto Reckless's Jhin. And CLG certainly seems to have the momentum early on, don't they?
Klai has really been underwhelming in this series. Yeah. He's missed a lot of skill shots, many, many mechanical misplays, as we saw right there, and it just makes it so easy for Afrimu to outplay him and Reckless.
I mean, technically that hook would have landed, but he was laning against Morgana, so makes it easy to avoid that. Darshan comes in, goes for the stun into Gamsu, but doesn't quite find it.
Again, it's the same problems for Fnatic. They're losing the two lanes, where technically they should be getting the advantage. If we look at the way Fnatic wants to play with their compositions, when you pick this Rammus top lane, you're not expecting to like super destroy it 1v1. It's more or less just gonna be farm lanes most of the time. So it's about Fevivin and Reckless becoming the carries. Last game they had a better 2v2, went even because Afrimu played fantastic. This one, picked a Jhin lane bully, lane into the Kalista, try and play aggressive offensive summoner. Roam away from the lane, get outplayed, 2-0 now for Stixxay on this Kalista, and also mid lane, this Pantheon coming in as a surprise pick for Fnatic and being swapped top lane when they saw the Quinn and the Rammus, or sorry, when they saw the Rammus as the last pick, and it's just meant that CLG have been controlling the two lanes Fnatic were planning on winning.
Very true. So far, the carries have been the only ones, besides the support, on the side of Fnatic to actually die.
Well, you also have to credit CLG's draft here, because even if they have some oddball champions, the fact that both Huhi and Darshan can play both of these picks is really what allowed them to do this. So as soon as the last pick was actually irrelevant, Fnatic thinking that they were going to have the Pantheon and Rammus matchup just didn't work out that way, easily swap back. So CLG definitely pulling out a bit of a secret strategy here.
He's farming, he's farming.
Oh, okay. I got excited. That's the first time I've ever casted a Jhin ultimate, but curtain call only used on minions.
And yeah, again, having flex picks, having bigger champion pools, it gives you so many opportunities in the pick and ban phase. Gams are going Rammus twice now. had some decent engages in the last one, but his team just fell so far behind. And now he's winning in farm because we saw the TP mid also from Echo. So at least he's doing his job, but the rest of Fnatic is not.
True. You know, we talked earlier, and our observers were kind enough to you know, vindicate me with my thoughts about Udyr grabbing the lantern. If we get a close-up shot of Quinn flying, I believe we can put this flapping, flapping discussion, this debate to rest right here, right now on this cast.
She's a flapper. Left.
We'll watch for that a little bit later. I don't think she is. I think she glides. I think her arms come forward via momentum when she stops, but she doesn't flap.
But she doesn't stop. She's still flapping.
No, no. She doesn't flap. We'll find out. You'll be wrong. You'll see.
We'll see. We'll see.
You'll see. DeFicio's on my side.
Undecided.
Oh, he is. Oh, Spirit gets caught in the tri-brush, taking a ton of damage, trying to get to the lantern. Makes it out, but will he live? Yes, just barely. Ooh, close one for Spirit. But CLG, you know, preventing any sort of aggression from Fnatic yet again. Feels a lot like game one in that regard, doesn't it?
CLG is just reading Fnatic over and over because you have your split pusher in the bottom lane and no one is against him. So obviously Gamzu is on top side and Fnatic is investing everything.
Wait, hold on. I don't see any flapping going on.
No, I don't see that either.
See, just gliding. That was not a flap. That was not a flap.
Flapping a bunch right there.
No, there's a fight. Never mind. There's a fight going on. CLG trying to back away as Quinn does not flap. Spirit gets low. There's a kill for Xsmithie. Zixxay trying to stay alive. Kiting backwards. He's finally going to go down. A double kill for Xsmithie, though, in the meantime. Fnatic turning this one around. Curtain call for Xsmithie. Can they get him? Doesn't look like it. Cocoon on to Gamzu prevents the follow-up. That was a close one at the end. But looks like Xsmithie gets the double kill, gets out. So kills on both sides in that one, but CLG still with the lead.
Yeah, CLG is not even using every single member
not flapping.
To either trade kills or defend against what Fnatic were doing before, because now they're just pushing in mid. Let's see what happens up top. So it's a dive against two members. Spirit is here and TP coming in. Meanwhile, there's no ulti coming in from Pantheon because it's on cooldown, and also no TP from the Echo. So this is just three members from CLG keeping Fnatic busy, trading 2-for-2, I believe, in the end.
Yep, that's right. Xsmithie finds himself in a 2v2 as well, but low health now. Darshan comes in to try to save his jungler, Reckless. Hops the ultimate, has to cancel it right away. He's in big trouble. They get the kill on Xsmithie. Clyde comes in to save Reckless. Darshan now from chasing. Nice grab on the Gamzu, but just not really any damage to follow up on that. Stixxay not quite there in time, so they do lose Xsmithie.
But every time CLG forces one of these fights, sure, they lose a member, but look what they're getting. They got turret damage in the mid lane last time and a TP advantage. Now they're going to use that TP, even though they lose a fight, to take out the tower in the top side.
We're going
to see if Fevin can do anything here, but who he is at near full health. And everyone from CLG simply going to be able to walk down. And again, just like we saw last game, it's just CLG totally outplaying Fnatic on the map. They simply have better communication and a better idea of how to use their resources in game.
And even outplaying mechanically in many, many ways, especially in the last game. And that's the problem. Sometimes we see teams being worse at macro, but then having better players and able to like set up some crazy plays you didn't expect. But in this game here in this series, Fnatic, every time they try something, it feels like CLG are just better.
Look at this, another turret for CLG. And man,
there's just no defense.
No,
they simply walked in. The wave clear just not there. Here comes Gamzu from the flank.
Stixxay taking a lot of damage. Aftermove comes in to try to prevent this engage. Spirit, there's a curtain call. Jhin with a lot of members of CLG to fire into right now. Stixxay taking some damage. That last one crits, but nobody goes down. CLG trying to defend their mid lane turret. Now they're all there, but they're all pretty low health. They get the minion wave though.
Oh,
Uhi
nice
gets
hook.
Grabbed. Yeah, nice hook right at the end of that ultimate. They're going to get the kill onto Pantheon. Fly. We've been a bit critical of his play, but that was a nice one right there.
Super good timing.
Yeah.
On the drop coming in. Very defensive drop still though from Uhi. I'm not sure if he expected Fnatic to actually push further. Is he Spirit?
Yeah, he wants those Raptors. Xsmithie wants a kill, but Fevman wants one as well. After move very low, has to flash away. Xsmithie, repel. Here comes Darshan, gets the stun into Fevman. It's a 1v4. Can't really make that work. Has to pop his ultimate to get out.
Really nice defensive play by Darshan. Ooh. Use of his ult right there, coming in with the parallel convergence.
Yeah.
And knowing that he could get out scot-free. We haven't even really talked about this, but one of the main problems with Fnatic's composition is that they just have no wave clear, like, at all.
That's true. They'll get the dragon, though.
It's one of these comps where you sacrificed the wave clear technically for more like roaming potential with a Quinn, stronger laning phase. It was supposed to be with Quinn and then the Jhin in the bottom lane, and you said, you know what, this comp, we know if we fall behind, people are gonna say there's no wave clear and it's awful, but we're not obviously planning on, we're planning on winning that early game super hard and then snowballing out of control, but it's but the risky comp.
Yeah, this is one of the issues that it brings is. Though. Yeah, I totally agree with you.
And that's the issue when you are now losing these lanes, also because the Pantheon surprised you so much against the Quinn in mid, that your comp will then get exposed to the weaknesses, being right. Lack of wave clear.
So if Quinn is moving and not hitting any terrain, she will not flap, obviously.
She doesn't need more speed, man.
We got it. Done.
So you both technically win.
But no, we don't.
No, actually, you lose.
I win completely. These analysts. Fnatic gets that mid lane turret. Aphromoo, not really in a position to make any picks. Throws a Dark Binding out, but hits a minion.
And this is good by Fnatic, because now you don't get in that situation where you have to sit and wave clear yourself and defend a tower. You're the one making the aggressive play moving up mid. Yeah. Problem is, you're still pretty far behind, and now you need
and
to...
And that's your first tower of the
yeah,
game.
Exactly.
Yeah,
and
right.
You need to put your under-level Quinn now in a side lane, so despite having three kills, Febben is technically behind in experience.
This has turned into a bird-watching expedition.
Are you a birder, Doa?
Apparently I am. I am this game. CLG grabs that blue buff away from Fnatic. Febben just trying to push the minion wave back away from the tier 2 here. And CLG, again, you know, I mean, despite the little missteps here and there, they get the pressure, they get the Dark Binding onto Spirit. Spirit throws his ultimate out, but there's, oh, nearly a pick. Nice save by Klai. Gets the Lantern there just in time.
Aphromoo is just in full control. Like, notice here, he just instant black shields his jungler because obviously the Morgana damage is irrelevant, and he wants Elise to be able to go in and try and finish off the kill.
Yep, they lost the turret up the top lane. Fnatic got it.
Gonna take a bot tower.
Gamsu's Rammus. Darshan on the run there. Febben finds him. Darshan waiting for that stun, but it's a little bit too late. Can Smithy possibly save him? Cocoon onto Febben. There's the kill. Who? He comes down. Actually, he just Mario stomps Febben to death there. Gets him right at the end.
Well, they have to split CLG up at this point in time. You need to actually get the split push rolling, because if you're Fnatic, that's probably the only way you're going to be able to come back into this game is using the strength of the Quinn in the 1v1.
Yep.
So instead, CLG just converge upon you and start to chip down your towers even further. They have been just running away with the current race. And
some damage for you, Klai.
Last game all over again. You fall this far behind early. Every play you make is a desperation play where there should always be a counter move for CLG, either take a tower or just collapse on them. The Echo top laners will be very happy, because I remember back when Echo was played a lot in top, he had to always rush Morello when Rod of Ages weren't buffed yet. Mm. And they were like, oh, I really want Rod of Ages because it's so good getting that extra HP, survive a little bit more so I can actually jump back to my ulti in these fights here and not just get instant popped and I have to use ulti early. Now it's been buffed.
Yeah.
So all the Echo players, there was basically the one we see here.
All of the Echo players.
Eyes around the world. They're super happy.
A couple of them.
Yeah, Huni loves that, I'm sure. Yeah.
I mean, it is a good pick. You just need a carry top laner to play it.
I think it's a decent pick, DeVizio.
Well, yeah.
I mean, it is interesting, though.
You don't know where I put, you know, the good in my ranking here. I could be, like, good into outstanding into, oh, my God, fantastic.
That is a weird ranking system you have.
Well, it's my ranking. I can do whatever I want.
That is true. That is true. I won't dispute that.
The DeVizio internal ranking system.
Changes from day to day. Well, Fnatic going to get the Rift Herald, so they've got that going for him.
Does explain a lot about the LoL Esports ranking system, though. That's the case.
Changes by day to day.
Well, so far CLG is
tier.
Destroying Fnatic and Europe's hope.
Hey, they are an A tier team. We know that.
We'll see if they can beat QT in the next game. That will decide
A is for averaged.
That sounds like the Monte Cristo ranking system there.
The next match will decide everything for that power ranking. If CLG takes down QG, everything is true.
Yeah, I actually thought CLG was looking pretty strong coming into this tournament. Definitely had a shot to make it out to the semifinals.
I mean, they still do. It's going to be tough against QG, but it seems like they aren't having too much trouble with Fnatic so far in this best of three.
Well, especially because the one kicker about QG is that we were criticizing their lane swaps, but it seems like in the first couple of games, a lot of those issues have been fixed.
Yep.
Well, a bit of a retreat right here.
Here we go. Nice dodge by Smithy, dodging pretty much everything coming in from Fnatic.
Looks like they may have caught Darshan. No, not quite. Fate's Call gets out from him closer. Can't quite land the Dark Binding, though. And it seems like whenever Fnatic has gone in on CLG this series, CLG has been ready to either disengage or turn it around.
It's
been so good.
When you play 1-3-1 with double global, you know, Pantheon ulti and TP from Echo,
yeah,
you can always just react as long as the three man you have power globals are together. Let's see what happens.
Yeah, Repel, where is he going to come down, though? Right onto Baron. Deadly Flourish doesn't connect from Reckless. Darshan gets grabbed, though. There's a kill for Fnatic. Who he comes in, tries to go for the stun on Gamsu, ends up having to flash out.
Stixxay's on the other side.
Yeah, I don't know what he's doing there. Okay, one, two,
vision.
Three,
and a crit,
one
crit.
More.
No!
Oh, it was close. He's going to die anyway, though. As Fnatic chases him down, Gamsu waiting for it. Got to go fast. Oh, there we go. Febivin, repel. Oh, he really wanted to give that one to Gamsu.
That was good by expecting giving it over to Gamsu. He was waiting.
It's a little bit less dangerous, you know, to give it to the Rammus, I suppose.
Yep. Definitely, but Fnatic winning a fight.
TP coming through on the bottom side.
That's right, might end up being dangerous. Here comes Gamsu yet again. Klai already a little bit low, but he just gets blown up completely. CLG, they need to get a little bit worried here. They've been caught out now quite a bit in the last few minutes.
They totally disrespected the fact that Teleport was still up in this mid lane with no tier 1 turret to protect them in a 5v3 situation. Great call there from Gamsu. And honestly, CLG's lucky that Fnatic's not going to get more out of this one. Just a little bit too early to be attempting that Baron.
Hello.
Oh.
Darshan finds Gamsu, stops that recall. I mean, it is Rammus, so he's not going to die too fast. But now Stixxay can speed that up a little bit.
Is he too furious? Yep. Yeah, he is. Gets away. In the end, though, Fnatic getting a few kills.
Blue buff.
Still behind. Yeah, that's also going to stop it.
Now CLG gets their first dragon, so that is even up then. They get the stats buff.
I want to see how that fight actually started with Fnatic catching them out near the Baron. Because, yes, it's been looking bad for them, but this is your way back in the game, obviously, catching them. Like, Stixxay is now on the other side of the Baron wall, so CLG is by no means in a position to fight.
It's really awkward.
Well, also just the chain CC, because the parallel conversions was up and could have probably successfully disengaged that fight, but getting the hook right after the taunt really did seal the deal on that one. And then we get to see Expathy's repelling to the target of his choice.
Made a deal with the Gamsu. All right.
Impaling himself on the...
This comes right down on the
swords
spike.
On his armor.
Make it fast.
All right, so the rest of CLG were trying to pick up a kill there. And then obviously Gamsu TP is in. I mean, he's been playing well in this Rammus. So now
another fight, though. Darshan taking some damage initially. Here comes Spirit over the side. Nice ultimate from that Gragas. After move pulled in with the Fate's Call, they're going to go onto the Gragas. Kills on both sides so far. But CLG may be in a little bit better position to follow up on this one. Xsmithy certainly seems to think so, but I don't know. It might be a little bit risky. Xsmithy, got to be careful. Dodge it. Gamsu taking some damage. Gets a ride out on the Lantern. So that fight pretty much goes to a standstill.
Wow,
CLG pushing a bit farther, though.
That could have gone a lot differently if Klai had landed either of those hooks, because he actually missed the hook on the stationary taunted target at the beginning of that fight, so they didn't get that same chain CC that they had in the first engagement.
Whoops.
As long as Gamsu can sit in the front line, though, then we see, like, CLG's fighting right now is Pantheon jumping in on the back line, but then the rest of CLG kind of moving back because either they get caught out, like Echo can never really get caught out because he has to jump in with the Pantheon to one-shot a target in the background. Then he can ulti out after. But he got taunted at first. And then Gamsu is basically standing in front of four members of CLG and saying they can't really move past him. And then Pantheon just ends up jumping in and he's all alone and dies. So it's, I like so far Gamsu's performance.
Yeah, it's certainly been effective. Febivin just going to push up the bottom lane a little bit now.
Yeah, not exactly. The ideal way to play Quinn for Febivin this game was going to be sitting in long lane and side lanes and push them out and then recall or roam through mid or through the river to mid lane and like try and play around the fact that Pantheon's ulti would have a cooldown where Quinn's ulti does not. You could just always pop it and you can play around the cooldowns. But because he fell behind early and has clawed his way back in.
Yeah.
By getting some kills and because he's a bird.
Pretty much. Well, they have claws.
Also,
thank you.
Also, Fnatic, they should just be able to respond to the minion waves faster with the Powerball and the ultimate coming in from Quinn. That's something that we haven't seen them do very well, is actually manipulate these minion waves and get the pressure that they need. But in theory, they should always be have that pressure advantage just due to their speed on the map.
And that's something we talked about like way back, first few minutes, about the roaming potential of Fnatic. But again, when you fall so far behind in the early game, you can't really push out side lanes at all, because there's always a threat of the enemy team just diving the rest of your team or going down and ganking you, and your lineup is pushed too far back on the map to then like take something if you die in a 2v3 or something in the bottom lane. So they haven't been able to play side lanes at all, which obviously hurt the composition quite a lot. But now with a few more kills, Quinn is getting stronger and stronger. Build a maw though against, I guess there is quite a lot of magic damage, but against the Pantheon, that's going to do absolutely nothing.
Well, Spirit gets caught. We'll see if he can make it out, trying to get closer to his teammates, trying to get closer to the Quinn, but that's just straight up a pick for CLG. We getting that kill, and with the jungler dead, how much Baron pressure can they put onto Fnatic here?
So much, because once again, you can't now play the rest of the map. You're forced to just teamfight as Fnatic, 4v5, because one member dies, so the 1v1 is completely broken. And CLG has all the control. Is there a pink ward though? There is a pink ward at the Baron. Blue trinket being popped in the back.
Yep. And still trying to make this pick here. And Fnatic is just not set up. Their only AoE CC they really have is Gragas.
CLG should start it just to force TP from Gamzu. If he showed bot lane, okay, he does not. Okay, so he's smart.
Oh, they find Klai though. Klai just gets destroyed. Whoa, that was another nice pick for CLG. And now they decide to start that Baron. Okay, I mean, a lot of CC out of the way with that Thresh dead for now. We'll see how Fnatic responds. Here comes Gamzu. Didn't have to use that teleport, of course, because CLG waited for so long. Turns around. They lock up Gamzu a bit. Darshan caught in the back lines. It's a trade. Well, actually, no. They got Gamzu. Darshan somehow stayed alive. But now, Reckless coming in with the ult. Gets one. Another one for Febivin. And Fnatic chases CLG off that Baron. Spirit's not done yet, though. Reckless coming through. Huhi, Darshan, everyone on the run. They find him. There's the exhaust. There's a kill for CLG. Now it's just Spirit. But so many low health members for CLG, they still need to keep retreating here. They can't really play this one too dangerously, even though they pretty much have all game.
Still a pretty early Barret attempt here, and yeah. CLG, not with too many true tanks, and they gave Spirit some time to get back into that fight in the first place.
Yeah, that was kind of the weird thing. You kill the Gragas, who's obviously a lot more impactful than a support, and you don't start the Baron, but you wait for him to respawn, then take another kill on support, and then you start the Baron. A little bit of a weird decision from CLG. I would like them to just start the Baron when they got the kill on Gragas to force the TP from Gamzu, and then the global pressure is pretty much gone from Fnatic. Instead, they delayed it. Gamzu came in, didn't have to use anything, sacrificed his life for the greater good.
Well, Huhi able to secure that blue buff at least. There's Febman again. Not flapping. It's going for the blue buff, though. CLG, they could try to respond to this. We'll see. Dark Binding lands onto Febivin. There's a little bit of damage with the Tormented Soul. Huhi goes in. They try to chain that CC. Febivin backs away. Huhi with the kill anyway. Now Gamzu, tanky, but in a bit of trouble. Gragas tries to disengage. Doesn't work. There's another double kill coming in for Huhi. Now they catch Spirit. A great fight so far for CLG. They may just leave it at that, though. They can push bottom lane. They can push the Baron. They can push the Dragon. They can really put any amount of pressure they want to onto Fnatic here.
You just take the inhibitor here. You have five members on that bottom side already. There's no need to go after the Baron. That's a secondary objective. The main goal should always be to do what you can to win the game.
Oh, flash cocoon onto Klai. Klai gets taken down, but a kill comes in for Reckless anyway. That's right, Stixxay gets a good angle on the side. Gets a lot of damage put on him, though. Whoa, there's more. Got to be careful here. Spirit comes in for an easy kill. I don't really know what Stixxay was thinking, being that far forward at that health.
He was tanking the turret that entire time.
CLG
are getting pretty crazy with the plays they're making here, and actually, again, giving Fnatic quite some chances to get a lot of easy kills. Suddenly, we've seen this before. Now, Gamzu's going to pick up another one.
Yeah, should be able to. Afremu with the shield avoids the knockup, but the ult just does work for him. Gamzu just needs to walk towards the guy.
25 seconds on Stixxay.
They have an opportunity to do the Baron right now.
They can rush Baron, yeah. I mean, CLG are playing a bit like Team Solomid yesterday in the first game against Ever, where, yes, you're super far ahead, but it doesn't mean you can take completely crazy fights and just abandon the way you were winning before.
Well, it's just sloppy turret aggro right there. And now with that TP, they're just going to start working this down. They can't do it very quickly.
Darshan comes in, really wants that Baron. He's doing damage either way. They're in there. Uhi gets the kill onto Fevavin. Baron gets taken by Xsmithy, actually. CLG got that one. Fnatic on the run. Shutdown comes in for Spirit, though. And Reckless doing a lot of damage from the outside. Fnatic ends up winning the fight. But at least CJ, or not CJ, I've been in Korea for too long. CLG takes the Baron away.
Darshan managed to pick up that Baron somehow. I'll have to take a look at the replay to see how that actually happened. Spirit not getting the smite in to take the objective cleanly. So CLG ends up with this. They're going to go after another dragon. By the way, this is only the third dragon killed this game at 31 minutes. It's just been all fighting.
I mean, CLG can do more damage to turrets this way. Not as helpful at 31 minutes in.
But it's 6 towers to 2 towers. Fnatic is ahead in kills, but obviously behind in gold due to it. And it's just been non-stop 5-man pushes from CLG or 3-man, and then all the globals kind of jumping into the same fight. And now the Baron calls. Right.
How do you get it?
Let's see. Pantheon ulti in. Gets Fevavin.
Just autos it.
Yeah, he actually just auto-attacked.
Okay.
The smite comes in from Spirit, and there's like, what, 10 HP.
Smite was just a little bit off, yeah. Gets it with the auto-attack, what do you know? And that means that now that people are back up for CLG, they can put some serious pressure on this bot lane again.
I mean, that steal was so huge. Imagine if Fnatic had gotten the kills they got and the Baron buff. Like, that's how you get back in the game completely.
Instead.
Auto-attack from Echo.
Wow. Didn't expect to see that one.
It also looked like the taunt came in immediately after that auto attack onto Echo in the first place. So certainly very, very close.
I'm going to rewatch again.
Yeah, I know you're taking a look at it. So CLG on the bottom side, they're still trying to push into this inhibitor. They do have the Baron buff on one, I believe, just on Stixxay, and otherwise not going to be willing to take that, but Darshan is a little bit overextended right here. He is going to be collapsed on.
Yeah, he's in a lot of trouble. Spirit, Gamsu flanking from the bottom. Fevavin, Reckless coming from the top. Darshan turns around onto Fevavin, tries to fight a little bit, but I don't know how you get out of this one. Answer is you ult and you die. So you don't. You don't get out. That's the answer.
So how did your research go there, Deficio?
AP Echo with his one auto attack on the Baron, took it.
With the passive?
I straight up hit it. I didn't even see if he had the passive. I think Spirit just smited on like 925 HP.
Yeah.
And then one little hit from the Echo.
Sometimes that's all it takes, right?
Because at this point, smite will deal like 800 damage from Spirit.
Well, this is like really lore appropriate because Echo is all about like, what can you do with one tiny second, right? Well, you can auto a Baron and steal it, I guess. Thank you for Darshan playing Echo in the lore appropriate manner.
It's just, is this a role playing server?
I guess so. It's our server. That's right. Whenever he kills someone, he's like, you don't deserve a single second.
Spirit is actually drunk right now.
He is literally intoxicated. Fnatic coming down. They want to take the tier one in bot. I suppose 33 minutes in, it's about time.
Fnatic's comms haven't been on point because all Gamsu will say is okay.
Okay. Curtain call used by Reckless just to
zoning
poke CLG away. That's right. It was a zoning ultimate.
Gets the tower though, again with Echo dying, pushing up another one. Ban of Command minion.
Yeah.
We're going to get a big 5-on-5, but the value of Pantheon also when it comes to these big team fights late game, when you start getting defensive items, his value kind of drops down. He's not really able to one-shot anyone. Still strong enough, though, if he gets on a Jhin, that he will kill Reckless.
Yeah. We might have to wait a little while for the 5v5. Darshan's TP not quite up yet. I suppose it will be in like a second now.
Yeah, just one few more seconds on that one. Fnatic got a lot more time in this game than they were supposed to.
Yeah, they did.
A lot more kills, and honestly still have a chance to take another team fight and almost close out the game. Because remember, guys, death timers are super, super long.
Yeah, I mean, if they can win a big team fight, they can certainly end it. We saw what happened with Ever versus TSM.
Yep.
It does seem very similar, doesn't it? CLG holding all the cards and just kind of giving it away by giving up on their team comp and playing a little bit too aggressively.
I don't even know if it was too aggressively. It was just too sloppy on that dive. And
some of the calls definitely a little bit too aggressive in the way diving in. Starting that Baron after only killing Clive, but not doing it when they actually killed the enemy jungler.
Yeah, that was a bit weird. He loves shooting wards. He's like, the way the splinters come off of the wards.
You want to know what the worst thing is as Jhin? Killing a pink ward. Because you only got four shots and then you got to stop and you don't kill the pink ward then.
It's true. And we'll see if Ex-Mythi gets killed. I think this is a pretty good pick. He manages to flash over the wall at the end, but that is so close. I mean, if you lose anybody now, you are in serious danger of losing the entire game.
1 minute 40 on Baron.
Yep.
130 or 23 on a dragon that no one probably cares too much about when we have two dragons to one.
Yeah, it's not as big of an objective.
It's just been a bloodbath to Fischio.
Yes.
It has.
It's been fighting, great. fighting.
Yeah.
And finally, though, they are going to be able to actually set up with this split push. They have Quinn in the top side, but she doesn't have teleport, so this could be an issue if Darshan decides to join up with everyone else.
We'll see.
I've been playing this very conservatively.
5-5-5. He doesn't want more deaths than any other number. So he's got to be careful.
Basically, don't join a fight, just split push the rest of the game.
Pretty much.
Well, we're gonna have a fight around Baron. Like, that's going to be it for both these teams. That's probably going to decide the entire game. There is a few deep wards, not too deep, though, from Fnatic to set up Gamsu's engage. Problem is, there's the Black Shield, there's Mikhail's as well from Aphromu, double Hourglass, QSS. I mean, there's basically just a jungler you can taunt. I mean, actually, at the Hourglass target, you can't taunt.
Oh, Styx A in a little bit of trouble. Gets slowed down, has to back away. Klai looking for a pick there. Flash play, really nicely done. Fevin comes in, 2-6-8 cleanses out, but that's a kill for Fnatic and Spirit. Now, Huhi goes in by himself completely over the wall. He is not going to make it out of that one. Reckless. Chasing in a very humorous manner. Curtain call. Huhi sniped. A beautiful flower. And now it's going to be really hard to stop Fnatic. Darshan gets hit by the Quinn. On the run, there goes another turret. And with a lot of the damage gone from CLG, I mean, how do you stop this push from Fnatic?
This is exactly the same thing CLG did against Immortals. Where randomly Styxxay and Huey would kind of get caught out a little bit. This time it's Styxxay in the mid lane.
Yep.
And yes, they still won the game, but it surely delayed it a lot. And this might even lose them the game. Fnatic getting the picks. There was no reason to push up mid lane with zero vision around you.
Well, they got the inhibitor, and they can go over and get Dragon. They can pretty much do whatever they want at this point.
Yeah, I totally agree with you, DeVicio. When we saw that Immortals game, Styxxay made some risky plays like Arcane shifting underneath enemy turrets in the top lane, which caused him to die. Huhi was caught out due to a mechanical misplay on LeBlanc in the mid lane, and it allowed Immortals. Now, Immortals did not win that game, but they had no business even being in that game in the first place.
Like, look at this. There's a pink ward in the bot lane bush, so they have zero vision, and they just randomly start pushing forward, getting caught out, and now there is enough CC to just catch you and flash after you and get the kill on an AD carry this late in the game. Well, super sloppy play.
Huhi also comes in with the Pantheon ultimate when there's no TP coming in from Darshan. So best case scenario, you're actually just jumping into a 3v5 right there.
Yeah, I mean, he tried to like trade himself for Reckless, but that didn't even work out. So now CLG is going to have a really hard time keeping Baron control with that minion wave pushing in mid lane.
It's impressive Reckless only died once in a game against Pantheon, Echo, even Elise, Morgana, technically. But it's also because in every fight we've seen, the Echo and Pantheon, the synergy, hasn't really been there. It's been like kind of one guy jumping in and then the other guy either ulting back if you're the Echo or very defensive ulti almost from the Pantheon, not in the back line, but then suddenly between the two teams. And it's meant that one guy would always jump in alone, either die or be forced out, and then the other guy would kind of enter. And obviously not be able to kill the Jhin, who's now been getting defensive items.
Well, a couple captive audience traps there in the river for Reckless. Did he really need to call it captive audience?
No, it's absolutely it's a terrible
flower.
Name.
Jhin I mean,
trap?
It's a flower.
Flower trap, I don't know. Like a Quinn asks Jhin what that is. He's like, captive audience. She's like, that makes no sense. Fnatic going for the Baron right now. CLG really needs to stop this one. Xmithy coming in.
Oh,
becomes a captive audience for a moment there. Aphromoo takes a lot of damage. Cocoon onto Spirit. Baron getting lower and lower. CLG trying to poke away at Fnatic here. They push them off of the Baron. The Baron is healing up, as we can see. Stixxay takes some damage.
Oh, Spirit, really?
Yeah, he goes for it, and he's getting a little bit low. Who he waiting to come in from the side? CLG losing some health. Aphromoo thrown in with the Fates call, and now there's a curtain call coming in from Reckless. We'll see what he can do with this. Gamsu locked up by that Cocoon. Who he on the run? Fevin comes in anyway. CLG on the defensive net right now, turning it around. They're going to try to anyway. Darshan goes in. Spirit has to back away for the moment. So does Clyde. There's a kill for CLG. Darshan going in another one for CLG. They trade as Gamsu picks up a kill onto Darshan, but this is looking okay right now for the NA team. Hui goes in, helps grab that kill onto Febivin, and now as Reckless finally falls, that is going to be the ace in favor of CLG, but they're too low to immediately push. Are they actually going to try for the Baron here?
Looks like that's going to be their call. And wow, Fnatic had, they could have had that fight so easily because Stixxay was actually rooted by Jhin in the front line. And for some reason, Spirit just didn't ult him into the team.
I don't know if they can do this, Baron.
Well, they got
this
Kalista Rent. As long as Kalista can tank it now and then Rent,
a little bit lower. There we go. Okay.
But also in that fight, in the end, Xmithy was standing behind the rest of the team.
Let's watch that replay. But we're past the Stixxay.
We're actually past the part where it mattered, but.
All right, so Stixxay at the Black Shield here. Some good traps, setting off with flowers or whatever it is from Jhin to deal some poke damage. But now look here. Notice Xmithy in the back. He's going to try and single out the Jhin, and he's actually making sure Reckless is dealing zero damage at this point. Just being as annoying as possible. You cannot kill the Echo in time, and now he's doing it to Febivan instead. So this is a Elise in the late game, taking out a carry. Not killing
two.
Him, but keeping them busy. Yeah, even two of them. Keeping them busy. Yes, he goes down, but this is a worthy sacrifice for sure.
Yeah, Hui just coming back in with that ultimate. And then Reckless can't handle the 1v3.
Yeah, we didn't actually see that. There was definitely an opportunity in the start of that fight for Spirit just to end the CLG immediately, and he didn't pull the trigger.
Yeah. So the gold lead for CLG right now doesn't really matter at this point in the game. Everybody pretty much has all the items they want to have. Fnatic actually with more kills.
And that just ruins everything Fnatic has been working for the last 15 minutes.
Yeah.
Punishing CLG for honestly misplaying quite a lot, being way too greedy and making some of the wrong calls.
So how do you take advantage of this now? They're pushing the bottom lane, but what else do you do?
I mean, again, you still have your globals with Pantheon ulti, so you can have two lanes with Baron buff minions pushing in, and the wave clear is not there for Fnatic. You also got two dragons, so you got the burn on towers. You just want to get in and chip away slowly.
Yeah, you just want to use this Baron buff the most.
Or you hard commit for the bot inhib and take a 5-on-5. Hmm. No tower, obviously, but can be tricky. Fighting so close to the base. If someone survives and he goes back and heals up and gets the home guards after a few seconds, he can re-enter.
It is true.
Definitely play two lanes. I even think the top tower, you can pick up that extra gold. The problem is the wave is super far away. If you see the wave on the minimap, it's going to take quite a while for CLG. So for now, it's hard to push through. Don't want to overdive anymore if you are CLG. You do want to hit this tower, though, just a few times to get the burn.
Yeah.
That's exactly
what Xmithy is going to do. And they do connect. Meanwhile, bot lane getting pushed by Huhi and Darshan. Here comes Spirit to try to stop this. I don't think that's going to work. Fnatic finally pushing a little bit out of their base, though.
And now even if you get onto one of these targets with Hourglass and you can like taunt them so they can't pop the Hourglass and try and kill them when they're CC'd, the Mikhail's here from Aphromoo is probably going to ruin that completely. And it's so difficult for Gamsu to find the target. Now we get the big wave coming.
Yep, that's right. And top lane's starting to push a little bit farther for CLG now.
As four cannons buffed up by the Baron.
That is a big push. Wow.
You ride this one all the way in, man.
Yeah, oh, yeah, for sure.
Glad we're on the same page, Monty.
Well, you
for sure.
You also have just so much split pushing pressure at the current time, and they're trying to make
buff
a play on
Huhi.
Oh,
there's no Baron anymore.
Yeah, the Baron just ended right now.
Still got
timing.
Four cannons.
Yeah, they do. Darshan's well, still split pushing down in bot.
Having a hard time getting around the caster minions into position.
Yep. Bevan trying to push Darshan away. He goes for the inhibitor. He gets it. He may have to give up his life for this, though. In fact, he will. Huh. And no, now Fnatic pushing out. I don't know. This is a little bit risky for CLG. They're down in a 4v5. They did get the inhibitor, though, I suppose.
Yeah, to get inhib, to get a tower top as well. So technically, it is fine for CLG. Hmm. Fnatic is so far back in the base. They might try and go for push mid, but that's why CLG is also hovering around topside to prevent that and make them maybe hesitate and go back.
Well, this may end up actually turning into a base race right now.
Don't do dragon. That's the last thing you want to do.
It's really dangerous. Actually, yeah, they're going in for the other inhibitor. They may just race this. Nope. Wow, is CLG actually going for this? They have to recall right now.
There's no minions for CLG just yet. Fnatic is pushing in. I don't know why, who he's doing dragon at this point. That has absolutely zero value.
He gives up right there, and they may... I don't think they're going to grab an inhibitor.
Darshan still has 30 seconds. How far are they going to push this? Looks like they're just going to send the boosted up minion here from the Banner of Command into the base, and that will quickly be eliminated and turn onto dragon themselves.
That actually ended up better for CLG, didn't it? Because they traded inhibitor for inhibitor, but they already had another one down. So in the end, it's... the next run for that. Right. Fnatic does get the dragon on the way out, though.
And also, pushing up mid lane versus super minions is so much easier than having to deal with the side lane with super minions, now that Baron is probably going to be a thing again in 2 or 3 minutes' time, if CLG is not pushing in for the win now, which they can. So, but you got super minions coming on the sides now, which is super hard to deal with for Fnatic, and you're already sitting mid.
Well, that wasn't very intimidating when you have a Thresh Lantern there and not even needed.
Watch out.
Get out of that. One less cooldown that Fnatic has to worry about in the upcoming contests in this game.
Jin's not actually very dexterous, is he? Drops that gun a lot.
On purpose.
Oh, sure.
We want to dance around, show the gun who's the boss.
Wants to work on his special edition Han Solo dodges. Don't make any sense.
It's interesting here that the two Thornmails are already constructed here for Spirit and Gamsu. Obviously, it's going to give a lot of trouble over to CLG. Darshan here, and CLG lacking a bit of damage here in the late game when it comes to these team fights. I mean, neither of these team compositions is very well suited to actually 5v5ing, so it's not, I suppose, that big of a deal. We're also talking about a Quinn here.
Still, Fnatic has to defend the side lanes, and Baron is spawning, so CLG will have an easy time setting up some wards around it. Problem is, when you go this late in the game, getting pink wards is pretty difficult, because there's probably only one guy who has room for it, that's his support.
No, we don't have room for it. We got to build damage.
Oh, you're right, right. Yeah, actually, no one can have pink wards here.
Just use your trinket.
So you see CLG, just pure green wards and then one pink on the map at the moment. Pippin pushing up bot side, meeting it early.
Yep.
And we're just waiting for Baron here, honestly. That's all we're waiting for.
And Fnatic trying to push that mid lane as well. I mean, anything to push your opponent back on the map right now, let you get closer to Baron, is definitely what you want to do.
Quinn having to help out in that bottom lane just to take out these super minions. So difficult for Rammus to deal with that pressure at this point in the game.
And it's just start the Baron, bait out the TP from Gamsu, disengage from the Baron, and then either you can take the fight because you have full vision around it, or if the fight doesn't happen, Gamsu has no TP and he can't defend the bot anymore.
Fevin's chunked out actually by the super minions here. He actually nearly died.
Wow.
He nearly died up there, so that's going to buy CLG quite a bit of time. He has to fall back straight to the Nexus, get back into his fountain, and then try and get out here. Remember, no TP on this Quinn.
And yet CLG didn't start the Baron to force that fight.
They knew
it.
They pinged him.
Yeah,
they pinged him. They knew he was nearly dead.
Started, and you can always disengage if you don't want to take the 50-50, but you do force a TP no matter what.
Darshan gave the 1v1. Why is he fighting Gamsu? I don't know what's going on there. He's got to get out of there. Meanwhile, CLG starts the Baron. This seems very risky.
No, it's extremely risky, and we see Gamsu still chasing Darshan around at the top side. Gets that shield from the parallel convergence, but he's still having trouble just dealing with Rammus auto-attacking himself to death on the Thornmail.
Fevin still having to deal with the super minions in the top lane. They're losing a lot of damage on that Nexus turret. CLG goes back onto the Baron again, gets forced back immediately by Fnatic, though. They're doing a little bit of damage here.
I honestly feel like it's a very simple play for CLG to set up. You don't fight the Rammus in the bot lane. You just start the Baron to try and force a fight and he's teleport. But by Echo jumping in and losing his entire
health pool,
whatever we want to call it.
Yeah, it works.
All his health points.
His red bar.
That thingy above him, above the mana.
That's right.
Well, then suddenly your play becomes super difficult because he can't follow and you actually just have to disengage super quick. More time for Fnatic.
Pretty much.
Can't really get more items at this point, though.
And we're back to square one as inhibitors start to respawn here. Be a temporary advantage for Fnatic. They did get a little bit later inhibitors, so that top lane will come up first. And now CLG has squandered all the opportunities they've had. We're in perfect six-item territory here. It's basically a crapshoot as to who is going to win this game.
CLG just didn't seem to have any real plan for closing out this game.
No, and let's see what happens bot here. Gamsu is now fighting super far up.
Yeah, here comes Hui though. Darshan trying to bait Gamsu in, but that is about the most tanky Rammus you've ever seen, and Darshan just getting destroyed, has to ult to get away. Hui chasing, Gamsu pops that ultimate. Hui comes in, Gamsu, I don't know if he can make it out. There's a flash, from Hui gets the kill. So that's one down, okay.
I don't understand how top laners in this game. Why is the Rammus now suddenly randomly fighting so far up with his team pushed back? Let's see what happens mid now.
Yeah, that's right. Fnatic backing away. Stixxay gets grabbed. Here comes Klai going in, drops the box right now. Everybody flashes out. Xsmithy hits the wall. Aphromoo went for the Dark Binding, but it hit a minion, though. Xsmithy trying to back away now. Got to be careful there. It's a 5v4 for the moment. Still about 45 seconds until Gamsu's back up, and CLG may try to use this one to go for a Baron. Stixxay taking a little bit of damage right away. That Baron will go down fairly fast. Here comes Fnatic, though. Yeah, they got to be really careful here. Hui lurking from behind. Wow, Spirit goes in. CLG knocked all over the place. Have been slowed up for just a moment. Stixxay manages to get one kill anyway. Aphromoo doesn't survive much longer. CLG looking okay here. They've traded pretty evenly. There's a nice pick onto Reckless. Here comes Darshan, and there's the shutdown for Xsmithy. Febivin, the only one left until Gamsu comes back. Pantheon wants to drop in and say hi, and they might be able to catch him. The minions giving Febivin away.
Gamsu has TP when he's alive in 1 second. Now they're pinging on the minion wave. He's using teleport.
Yep.
Trying to save his teammate.
This could end up being a little bit crazy.
Is CLG going to commit to this?
Yep, maybe they are. Gamsu coming down. He can do a lot of damage. Febivin can help out. Xsmithy there over the wall. Flash Cocoon doesn't connect. Gamsu tearing apart CLG here. This is a bit messy. There's the rappel. Waiting for it. Coming back down again.
He's not done.
Nope, not quite yet. Gamsu can come back in. He can fight this all day, man. This is crazy. Febivin gets Darshan. CLG just can't disengage from the fight they started. And this is about as messy as it gets, isn't it?
Oh, this game is crazy. Man. I don't even know what Gamsu was fighting in the first place in the bottom lane. That's a super bad play for him. So here's the engage, 4v5. They don't manage to get a kill in the start. Some hourglasses in there, defensive items. Reckless can't move too far forward, even though he's so farmed at this point. And now you see Jhin. No extra mobility really to help him out. He gets cocooned and then you go down. QSS were already used. And then we get the chase.
Yep. They didn't need to chase, but they decided to do it anyway.
By the way, about Jhin's AD in the late game, Reckless is sitting on 725 AD at this point.
Wow. Well, CLG pokes that Baron again. I feel like I've seen this before. Febivin coming in.
Oh, from
Gamsu from the flank. Yep, that's right. He could cause a lot of trouble for CLG. Aphromoo completely caught out. He's going to go down, pulled back by the Fates call for the moment anyway. Stixxay trying to kite back as much as he can, but here comes a curtain call for Reckless, doing a lot of damage. Klai zoning out on the side. Stixxay solo. Febivin looking for it. Can he get it? The kiting. Xsmithy comes back in. They're under the turret now. Fnatic still looking good, though. There's a kill for Reckless, rather. And I think Fnatic may have this one. They only lost Spirit. Febivin very, very low. Darshan wants to try to make a play, but I don't know if you can here. Yeah.
No, they can't end. Gamsu and Febivin so very low in that engagement. And with Echo and Kalista still up, it's not enough just for Reckless to go for it. So they can turn perhaps onto the Baron right there.
It's crazy. We're about to reach 100,000 gold each for these teams. Let's watch this fight again.
All right, so it's the flank from Gamsu getting Aphromoo. Yes, he gets pulled in it in, but he's out of the fight now. And you can just continue chasing Spirit and Gamsu in the front line. So CLG just has no damage against Gragas and Rammus at this point. And as long as they're in the front line, it is so hard to do anything.
Man, that cocoon from Xsmithy. And look at this, Fnatic.
actually grabs that Baron away.
Yay, Dragon 3!
Yeah, Dragon 3 at 54 minutes. Wonderful.
I can't believe we've only had 6 dragons in this game at 54 minutes.
It's because we've been too busy having 55 kills in 55 minutes.
This is not Korea, man. We want kills here.
No, this is China.
Oh, and like Europe. An LPL game and North America.
And, all right, everywhere but Korea.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, I don't even know what to think about this game anymore, Divizio.
Is there really much to think about?
Quality solo queue. No, I mean, we've seen some good calls, but we've also seen some super weird calls from the teams where a random member is overextending or they're diving too far 55 minutes in, and it's still a fairly even goal. I mean, that's crazy.
Gamsu is so huge right now.
Oh, Pantheon is not even full built yet.
Oh, yeah.
But did he just sell something to get the BF sword?
Maybe. Fnatic coming in, they want to claim this inhibitor, and I don't think they're going to have much of a problem doing that.
Nope.
Reckless has to be super careful playing on the front line like that. Yes, he has a Steric's Gauge, and he's a little bit on the tankier end, but he is certainly taking a few risks there.
Rotating over to top lane now. Another undefended inhibitor is going to be the next target for Fnatic. At 10-3-15 on this Jhin for Reckless. Pretty good game. CLG, they might need to fight this pretty soon. I don't think Fnatic's going to stop rolling through their base anytime soon.
Well, certainly not if Gamsu is alive with his Powerball.
Yeah. Tough to stop.
He's moving.
No, he's just going to keep rolling.
That's because he's tough to stop. Well, the dance continues. And Fnatic obviously wants this inhibitor. CLG, can they go in? Parallel convergence attempted by Darshan. Spirit gets locked up a little bit, takes some damage. Has to be careful, though. Still a lot of poke coming in from Fnatic. Reckless taking some damage as well, but nothing he won't be able to heal up from easily. And Reckless gets grabbed by the Dark Binding. Yeah, are they going to engage? Not quite. Gamsu caught out a little bit. He's tanky, but in the 1v5, he's going down so fast. Nice ult, though, comes in from Spirit. CLG on the run again. Reckless in the back doing so much damage. Gets the first kill of the fight. Gamsu finally does go down. It's a 1-for-1, but the kills are going to keep coming in for Fnatic. Hook on Aphromoo blocked by the shield. CLG, though, I don't know if they can stop Fnatic at this point.
No, you got Baron buff minions here, four members alive. Reckless is so fed, and he's getting more kills.
Oh, Stixxay coming from the side, doing a lot of damage with that Kalista, actually.
Oh, he didn't get him.
Might be enough damage. We'll see. Stixxay being a one-man army here. Whoa, but that was almost a one-shot on the one-man army. He needs to back away as the first Nexus turret falls. And Fnatic looking like they should be able to close this one out unless we see a miracle right here, right now. Aphromoo Stixxay, they want to try it out. They get a couple, but I don't think it's going to be enough. Look at the damage on the Nexus, and Fnatic at 58 minutes ties up this series. GG.
Well, if you told me, I would have seen an Echo Pantheon Quinn Rambus Jhin game today. I would not have believed you.
Welcome to IEM.
I would have either. Yep.
Honestly, no, I mean, the picks made sense. That's the best part of it. The Pantheon Echo last rotation to potentially, you know, have the swaps around. So the picks actually made a lot of sense. It was super smart. And then late game, like Jhin, great laning phase. Then in the mid game, he is not the strongest. You want to pick people off, and he's very risky to play because, again, low mobility. But then late game, 725 AD, and the guaranteed crit as well.
I mean, we were seeing some of his curtain call crits go for over 2,000.
I think I saw one for like 2.7. I'm like, okay, this guy is doing some damage now.
He's fed.
Well, to assess the damage, it's time to send it over to the analyst desk and see what they thought about that one.
Well, listen, there's simply not enough time or analyst desk segments for us to actually break that game down. So we're going to chain together a few replays and try to explain how the game played out with the use of replays. The very first one is a good summary of maybe the first 20 or 30 minutes. Pull it up onto your screen, and this is the first time that we saw Huhi use that man drop. Yep. Roll the clip out, picks up first blood, and then goes bottom lane. Dexter, this allowed CLG to get a lead early on in the game, but
we talked about tempo, and I think that CLG got like all the tempo they needed in this game to actually open up the map from that. And if you see it, the counterplay comes in, and they get a first blood. Who is gonna hit level 6 off that creep wave? Ghost bottom, and then the game from this point is going to become like super hard for Fnatic, and they just have to play scaling game.
Well, they played the scaling game. 58 minutes of scaling. Second kill picked up. Really nice work from our observers, by the way. Not planned at all, because if you guys at home are using the plays.tv Chrome extension, you could record that and share it on all of your social media. Go check it out on the Google Play Store. Once we're done with that one, let's pull the second replay up onto your screen. This is going to be a lot later into the game. Yeah. It will take just a little bit of time for the guys to get ready. This is about 30 minutes in. And Mythy, CLG keep pushing, keep trying. They keep getting caught out. This is about the fourth or fifth time. Pull the replay up onto your screen. And CLG just overcommits onto this inhibitor fight. How bad is this from CLG and how good is this from Fnatic?
I mean, it just goes both ways, right?
I know. Like,
sure, it's good by Fnatic, but it's also bad for CLG. I just think that overall, in general, CLG could have, like, sure, Fnatic outscaled them later on, but I think just CLG just had to slow down a bit and just play a bit more the macro game out of the advantage we saw in the first replay. I think if they played the macro game a bit more and just didn't go for this many risky situations, they would have eventually snowballed Fnatic to the point where they were just choked out so much that they could just win the game.
Well, this replay goes on for a little bit because you're about to see Gamsu teleport in and kill Aframu. And Dexter, the replay's not done then Fnatic go to Baron. Yeah. This is one of the many Baron... I'm going to use the word call. Yes, attempt is a great word. It's not the one I was thinking of. But, like, how do you describe this, you know?
That was a Baron dance.
Yeah, Baron dance. What's communication like, Dexter, for these teams? CLG obviously trying to prevent it. Fnatic trying to play for it. They're still down, like, 5k gold.
I mean, Fnatic should actually take this Baron, but, well, there's the smite, and Echo got it. I guess someone failed smite, it happens.
Yeah, do you tilt when that happens? Huh? Do you tilt in the game when that happens?
To be fair, yeah.
How does it feel as a jungler?
It's like the worst feeling in the world. If you fail smite Baron, and you lose the game off that, it's, yeah.
The official went and watched it, like, frame by frame, yeah. And it was an auto attack from Echo. Oh. Like, that was it. That's all it was.
Bad, man.
Now, that was at about 30 minutes into the game. There was another 30 minutes of team fights. We had 60 kills in total.
Yep.
Make some sense of this game for me, Mythy.
It was a scrim. That happens in scrims usually, what you saw in that game.
But do you play it out for an hour?
Gotta do what you gotta do, right? No, it's just overall, in general, the game was... CLG had an advantage. They tried to push it. They failed to push it. Fnatic was fighting for their lives in the tournament, so they tried their hardest to come back, to stall out the game. They knew they had the late game. They played. They had the late game at some point, but then they didn't play fights out as well as they could have. And then eventually they kind of just, through fighting, figured out how they are supposed to play. They got even some more items going on. The Jhin late game is just, like, she has a mid game power hole, but late game it's just, I actually had this Twitter people telling me that it's a he.
It's a he, yeah.
Know, it's just the cowboy hat, you know, it makes him so sexy, you know. I just thought she was a he.
Welcome to our life. Rek'Sai being a she, the queen of the Xer'Sai. I still get angry tweets about that. What did you think of Reckless's performance on that Jhin? You've mentioned the champion in terms of the strength of the game. He ended up going 11-3-17. I felt like he was safe, but I also felt like he missed a lot of ultimates. Is it difficult to land? What was your take on his...
I think at start he was just warming up, you know,
okay.
Shooting a bit, seeing if it hits or misses, and then later on he was actually hitting some good ults. He was slowing people down so his team could catch up to them and so on. So I think overall he played a really good Jhin. I give him a
okay.
good grade.
Nice, okay, good grade. Dexter, you incorrectly predicted the winner of this game. So I'm just going to throw you
in. I don't think there was a winner of that game. For
yeah. You know, I think that is incredibly fair. We're going to hang on that note because the series is tied at one game apiece. When we come back, Dexter, Mythy, and I will set up game 3, the deciding bout for NA versus EU. It is Fnatic versus CLG. We'll be right back.